Hello viewers, now we will study about Tally ERP. Tally is the simplest and complete business solutions available in the world. Today, over 20 lakhs users across 90 countries are using Tally to expand business and to enhance their performance. Who can learn this Tally? Anybody who has a prior knowledge of accounts or a basic knowledge of English can use Tally. By using a business accounting software like Tally 9, you'll be able to integrate and streamline all your business processes easily and cost effectively. When it comes to ERP software, Tally is offering Tally ERP 9 for a small and medium business to manage their enterprises efficiently for over 3 decades now. Tally ERP 9 is being used by business owners across India to manage their day-to-day operations and generate required business reports, which helps make important decisions. Dear viewers, working with Tally is always an enjoyable experience. Tally ERP was designed and to automate all your business operations easily. One of the major important or striking feature for the Tally is Tally does not support code accounts. The only reasonable way to keep your record is used to use for your account. With Tally ERP 9, a business owner can easily create and track sales vouchers and get detailed reports on a daily, weekly, monthly or yearly sales basis. With Tally 9, you can maintain your accounts in any Indian language, view them in another and print them in yet another language of your choice at the same time and really fast. This opens up greater business opportunities as you can transact across the length and breadth of India and many other countries without worrying about language barriers. Inventory management in Tally. Tally ERP 9 can be used to manage stocks in a very flexible manner. You can define unlimited stock groups, stock categories, and arrange stock accordingly. Get reports based on stock groups and categories to get an overview of stock status across locations. Security features in ERP software. The Tally Vault password encrypts and safeguards data from unauthorized access. User level access and controls can be defined and granted by the configuring the user management settings. ERP software functionality, remote access. You need to access business reports or add new business transactions remotely. Security is a typical corner when comes one has to access business data from other locations. With Tally ERP 9, you can take important business decisions when necessary by accessing business data securely and making updates as required. The Tally screen, you can see the two divisions will be there. First one is list of selected companies, that is left side. Whatever the companies we opened earlier will be shown in this particular column. Next, right side will be the company info screen. That is, we'll have options like select a company, login as remote user, create a company, backup, restore, quit options will be available. Next is the top, there is a option will be, that is nothing but this is Tally licensed logo will be displayed here, and this is print options will be available here, export options will be there, here mail options will be there, upload options will be there. Tally Shop is one of the important feature for the Tally. We can buy the additional software related to the Tally. Next is we can have the language settings will be here, and keyboard for the language, control center, support center and help. Next, here at the bottom you can see the Tally product logo. It's a Tally, indicates the power of simplicity, Tally ERP 9. And next is the version and updates will be available here. Series A release as 6.5 latest release in. Next, license and services. Here, whenever you buy that particular software, I said there is a two types of license will be available. That is silver mode and gold mode. And next is here, educational mode will also be there. Next is we'll have a configuration view there, gateway and ODBC server. We can next, this portion is known as a calculator portion, where we can work with the calculator whenever we have a calculations like depreciation or bad debts calculation. Any calculation you want, you can do with the help of this calculator. And this portion is known as a button area. This portion is known as a button area. This is called minimize, this is maximize, and this is canceling this program. Next is, you can see this red letter will be available here. When I click here, when you pull down here, you'll see another letter, red letter with the L. Next is C will be the L, and B is the L red letter, and R is the red letter, and Q is the letter. These are mentioned or known as a hotkeys in the Tally. Suppose I can select this particular option by using the mouse, or I can also use the up arrow, right arrow, up arrow, down arrow, or otherwise I can also select this option by pressing S. Here, when starting letter S indicates the selecting of a company, L stands for login as a remote user, C stands for create a company, B stands for backup a company, backup the company data, or R stands for restore a company data, and Q stands for quit from this Tally. Now, for the time being, we will learn how to create a company, first option. Now I can use the create a company. I selected a create a company option. Just I click this, I'll get a one screen will be opened here. This is the create a company screen is available. Next is here, first one will be the directory. Means directory is indicates that where our Tally files will be stored. Here there is a, it we have installed the Tally in the C colon, that is C drive, under the users, public tally.erp9/data. This is the folder where all our company details will be stored in the this particular folder, that is C colon users/public/tally.erp9/data. Next is, we have to give the name of the company. Whatever the name you are going to put, you have to give the name of the company. For example, now I want to select a Ding Dong Bell Company. So I'll say Ding Dong Bell Company. Ding Dong Bell Company. Dong Bell Company. COMPAMY Company. Next is the mailing address. Automatically, the name of the company is copied here. I can copy this, I can put this, I can say fourth block, RV Road, Jayanagar. I'll write Bangalore. Next, I'll write address. If you are having a further address, you can write. Next is, this is the where the company is located, you have to put. This is, there are the different list of the company. These are list is available. Suppose I said no, this particular Tally software is used in worldwide. So the Hong Kong people will select the Hong Kong country, and Egypt people will select the Egypt company country, and Libya, Malaysia, Kingdom of Bahrain, Kenya, Jordan, Iraq, Indonesia, and these are the list of companies are there. Now I'm selecting the company called India. Next is, I'll select the state. There are different states. Now when I select the India, and we have to select which part of the country we are belongs to. Now I'll select K. I'll click K from the keyboard. When I click from the K from the keyboard, there's a Karnataka and Kerala, both are highlighted in blue color. So whichever the state you want, just you can select it and press enter key. That particular state will be displayed into the display, and you can select it automatically. It will be printed in the state place. Next is, we have to put the pin code. Now I'll put 5600078. That is, I'm selected the pin code and phone number. If you're having a phone number, you can add phone number. Just I like table text 9023. Next is mobile number 9880501 2 3. Next is fax number. If you're having, you can put. Now email ID. Now you can put any email ID. Ram ramcurrent@gmail.com. Just whatever, just you can just next website. If a company is having website, now you say ding dong bell ding ding dong.com. You can write the company name. Next is, this is a financial year. You are clear with the there is a financial year concept is available now here. Now every financial year starts from 1st April to 31st March is the financial year. And you can have we can maintain the different types of financial years are there. April 1st to March 31st is the one of the financial year. Next is calendar year is there. January 1st to December will be there. Like this, we can have the different financial years. When the tally, always the financial year starts with the 1-4 particular year will be there. Now this is 2019 is there now. Just I am selecting as a financial year 1-4 2019. Next is the books begin from. Suppose when we suppose the business is started in June, the fin of June of 2019, the books beginning date should be 1-6-2019 will be there. I am putting 1-6-2019, and this books begin date should be always lies in between the financial year. I cannot write 1-6-2020. Why? Because the financial year will be crossed, because 1-4-2019 to 31st March 2020 is the financial year. If I put 1-6-2020, means it will be the tally will show the error message will be displayed. And here now I started 1-6-2019 is the book's beginning date, and always this book beginning date should be lies in between the financial year only. Next is, I'll go to this particular company called Ding Dong Bell Company. Just I'll give the password as TEST test 123 I'm giving. Now it will show you that tally vault password strength is weak. Only thing is, when we want to make the strong, we had to use some other function, some other characters like uppercase and lowercase letters with numbers and all those things. We'll be getting the we can set the password as a strong. Now we are only practicing. Now just I give ABC 123. I'll give at symbol once again 123. Now I'll add once again ABC. Otherwise, you see, now we are getting ABC 123 at capital letters. I use ABC 123. Now we got the password strength is very strong. I have to repeat the same password. Now you see ABC now. First I entered small letters ABC 123 at caps lock. I'll say ABC 123. Now the password, both the passwords are matched. Now whenever you the and you are not supposed to forget the password. Now there is a tally will give the warning, forgetting the tally vault password will render your data inaccessible. If you want to go for a security controls, you can go for yes. Otherwise, you can select it as a no. Now I am selecting yes for the security user. Yes, I'll say the name of the administrator admin. I'll give password is also admin. Now we have to repeat the same password. Now it is not showing. It is very weak. Forgetting your password will render your data inaccessible. Press any key. Now here also you are not supposed to forget the password. Now this select no. Now base currency symbol rupees, formal name Indian rupees, suffix symbol amount, add space between amount and symbol yes, show amount in millions. Suppose if your business is growing up to millions, you can make it as yes, otherwise no. Next is number of decimal places to number word representing amount after decimal, basic number of decimal places for amounts in words, do. And when after doing everything, we have to select the accept screen, that is called yes or no. When we say yes, means the company is created. Now the company is created. Now we have given a Tally vault password to open that company. You have to give ABC123. So the company is over. Now we have to open the admin. Here also admin. So the company's creation screen is completed. Now it's a gateway of Tally. It's the main the second screen of the Tally will be opened. Now this is the way how to create a company. Now I said earlier this is a button area. Now you see here there is F1 is for select a company. F underline F1 shut company. Alter key we had use alter F1. F2 for date. This is period. We want to set a period. We'll use the period option. Next is the F3 company info screen. And F4 connect screen. F4 disconnect. Synchronized. All these details will be available. Now F11 for features. F12 for configuration. Now I want to make this. Suppose this is a company we have created. I want to close this company. Means just I can use Alt plus F1 or shut a company. When I close this, we'll get a shut a company, means this company is closed. I want to open a company once again. I'll use the select a company option. Now when I press, I'll getting this company information screen will be available. Now you see this, there is a Geo College, Cost Center, Apple, something is there. Now here we are able to view the name of the companies. Why? Because these companies do not possess any Tally vault password. Now we have to distinguish these stars are indicates that this company is protected and it is having a Tally vault password. When you are having a Tally vault password, we will not be able to see the name of the company. We will see in the form of stars. Now these are the company numbers. Actually every company will be, whenever we create a company, the company serial numbers will be generated automatically by the Tally. Now I'll select this 1005. I'll select this 1005. I think this will be the. Now I'll give this. I'll give the Tally vault password. We give ABC123@ABC123. When I give this, I'll give the ding dong company open. Admin. Here say admin. The company is open. So whenever you give the right password, the company will be open. Now we have seen how to shut a company and how to open a company. Now I want to make corrections in the address of the company. Suppose when we move from one place to another place, we have to change the address. We cannot change the address, only that same address will remain, because in Tally there is an option to make the corrections in the existing company's information. Now there is a, once again I'll go to the company info screen, Alt F3. Now you have to go for a alter option. Here there is an alter option is there. When you create an alter option, we can go for an alter option. When we can make the changes here, whatever the changes you want, we can make the changes here. Suppose I want to change the email address bbc@gmail.com. just I did. I want to make corrections here, so we can change it here. So I'm changing admin password also. Admin. So but same thing will be here. So I made the corrections here. Next is, there is an option we can change the Tally vault password also. If you want, you can change the Tally vault password. All these things can be done with the help of alter company information screen. Now we want to come out from this Tally. we want to come out from the Tally, just click on the print option and we'll be coming out from the Tally. Very simple. Okay, listeners, now we'll learn how to create a company and how to alter the company. Now we next class we'll learn about how to create ledgers and groups, etc. Thanks for watching this video.